There has been a tussle at the top. Market valuations just keep on being allocated to Nvidia. Is that the right step?
Well, I think that Nvidia is making the headlines and they're doing a great job. Not only that, they are making huge progress on their numbers. They do make enormous forecasts and they beat them by very comfortable margins quarter after quarter, but they come very regularly with new updates, with new promises, with a new idea of, for example, creating an ecosystem, offering hardware, software, and services. So they are making the AI a full environment where everybody could be interested and everybody will find their, well, what they're looking for. So in this sense, Nvidia looks like it's still a step ahead of the other competitors. And in terms of PE ratio, what we see is that even though the prices are going higher, well, the PE ratio is not going that high because, well, the earnings actually do follow up.
Ipek, let me show you this chart. And it's a busy one. So I'll explain what it is that we're looking at. If you think about it, big picture, Nvidia is just a few percentage points away from exceeding Apple's market cap, from having a market cap greater than Canada's equity market. And 10% or so would take it beyond Microsoft to be the world's most valuable company. Is that justified to your mind?
Well, I can't really tell you this is justified, but today with the AI revolution, Nvidia has been catapulted to that place of the leader of this market and the leader is in a revolution. So this is not something that happens every year. This is once in a decade or once in a few decade thing. If AI is the next big thing after internet, then Nvidia has got a huge opportunity, a huge potential to increase its business. And now we are reading the reports that Nvidia is not selling chips. It is now selling an environment. It is selling a dream. And it is actually selling us a new life, a new way of doing things, and now we are just at the beginning, and people know that the opportunities are simply huge. So yes, as Apple has become one of the world's most valuable companies because, well, they just got this iPhone in our hands, well, Nvidia could very well become the next big thing by, well, putting AI in our, well, devices and make our lives completely different from what it was before.
I really like that you've referenced Apple there. Ultimately, because the market capitalizations are vying with each other. But in our Tech News Daily, there's a great thought leadership piece there. Ultimately, that Apple did this previously. It won out by having a sort of closed wall ecosystem, whereas Google went, say, hey, everyone can play in our garden. Whereas we're seeing that sort of playing out with Nvidia versus the likes of, well, of course, the other competitors that we've heard for, whether it be Intel working with all the other particular players out there, Ipek. I'm interested in not just the analogy between Apple, what's happening in China? I know you've had some thought leadership there from your own, and whether we should, or if you can, invest in Chinese AI, they might win out too.
Well, actually, we think that Chinese technology and AI-related companies are intriguing because we know that in this context of technology war, Chinese government is putting a lot of weight behind its technology and AI companies. And China does have this pool of very big technology companies that have been once very popular, that still is in China, and that have a proven track record, and that are right now trading at extremely low valuations compared to the US peers. I mean, we are talking about a PE ratio of around 10 to 20 for the big Chinese technology stocks compared to 6 to 6 for Nvidia and hundreds for AMD, for example. So in this context, they're cheap and interesting. Now, one risk is the geopolitical and political risk. I'm going to put that aside. But one other risk right now is the fact that these technology companies in China are in a fierce competition against each other. And they are mostly focused on expanding their market share rather than maximizing their profits. This is something that keeps investors a little bit reluctant regarding the Chinese technology stocks. But this is temporary because ultimately one or a few of these technology stocks are going to be the winners of this AI revolution in China. And that day, as an investor, well, you want to be in that elevator.
We started this program with Pat Gelsinger's belief that Moore's law is intact, that they will regain a foothold in the market. Is the addressable market big enough to have AMD, Intel, and Nvidia all offering into the same thing?
Well, I think the market is huge. the opportunities are huge. But what's going to matter is not only how fast and how efficient the chips are, but it's also how well the service and the ecosystem and the environment that these companies are going to offer. And it looks like Nvidia has, well, a very good understanding of this 360-degree offering. So it's not going to be about chips only, but it's going to be about who is going to offer the best service to, like, the most of the companies on the face of this earth, not only to big technology companies, but to companies across most sectors. So I think that in this sense, yes, there is demand for a lot of chips because the AI revolution is happening and we are all concerned with it. But the real winners are, I think, going to be not the best ones in terms of their products, but also the ones that are going to be offering all the environment and the universe with it.